my ambitions. 하나 둘씩 완성돼야 made it. Hi, 안녕하세요. Edgy, I don't know. It's probably because of the song.
No.
Ah!
What the fuck?
For fuck's sake!
Fucking come on!
No!
Don't fucking jump at me!
Yeah, so last week, because I didn't have time to put on Chinese Room, I saw you guys in the car, but today I'm here in my room. Yes, so today we are gonna have a great time. Woo-hoo-hoo! Why'd you cover the number plate? I mean, well, I think it's basic common sense, because, I don't know whose car it was, but we can't have their details, spread out, so I try to cover it as much as I can. So today we're gonna listen to a lot of music because through Fansign events you gave a lot of recommendations. I tried searching the things that I could play or not, and we will also be listening to a few songs that I prepared, because why not? I mean, this is a really bad screen capture. It was here.
Wakey wakey.
A little funny thing about Scars would be, I don't know if it's funny, but like, I actually made the track 2-3 years ago. It was at our waiting room, for Kayote Chukje. Yeah, and that's when I made it. I don't know why, it just came out of nowhere. I was like, oh, I'm gonna make a track, and then we made Scars. So anyway, yeah. So the first song for today is actually a Spanish song. So we're gonna listen together. Let's go.
Everybody dancing, baila, move your feet, it sounds like.
So this song is Stand By Me, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people know what the song is, and it is by Prince Royce. Mm-hmm. I do remember Stay told me about the song, and it was like, oh, it's in Spanish, and she wanted to, make me listen to it, and I was like, yeah, sure, and then here I am. Now, I'm really, really not familiar with Spanish language, but if I'm allowed to say my opinion, I do want to say that, the Spanish language, it's really smooth, and I think it's really, really romantic and really sexy. So I think this version of Stand By Me is something that I'm probably gonna remember, because it was really, really good. And of course, the singer himself, I think he executed it really, really smoothly as well. So yes, thank you for the recommendation. So I'm actually really mad because, we couldn't get to go to Spain, because I really, really wanted to go, because I've never been in my life. It would have been a first to go with Stray Kids, and we were so hyped for it. But unfortunately, we weren't, it's the circumstances, it couldn't be helped. But if there's something that I really want to do, I really want to go to Spain. I really want to, experience the culture, the language, the people, everyone there, and yeah, when we get there, let's make sure to have a really good time. Chan, you look swollen. Do I look swollen? I think I do. I'm gonna look swollen because I actually recently got my wisdom teeth removed. So my lower ones, they actually they grew sideways, right? They didn't grow upwards, they grew sideways, so I had to like break it down to take it off. But yeah, it's been like 4 or 5 days, 5 or 6 days, but yeah, it doesn't hurt. Yeah, so I've got stitches inside, but it's all good. No pain, no gain. Yeah, I've been watching a lot of Casual Geographic videos because I was always a fan of animals and like wildlife and whatnot, and seeing someone teach a lot of things that we don't know about animals in a very casual and like a one-to-one friend, I know this person kind of way, it's really, how to explain, it comes in really, really nicely. Like, sometimes when you're at school and a teacher is explaining, but sometimes it's too hard to understand, and then it's kind of, it doesn't, go into your brain that hard, like that easily. What am I talking about? But this is something that I hope would, you know, apply to a lot of different educational systems, but I feel like if you have fun, or if, you know, the learning process itself is really entertaining plus educational, then that knowledge will really, you know, come in like really well. I did not put that properly, but you know what I'm saying. And I actually want to, you know, say thank you to the guy, because I feel like it's really, really helpful. And I think it's a really, really good example of showing how people, especially in like the younger ages, of how they would take in different information. Because if it's delivered in a language where it's a similar age, then it's more easy to understand, and it's a good lesson. I know what I'm saying. But anyway, it's really fun, and that's what I've been watching. But seriously, I think it's really, really important for any educational system to know the language. I mean, it's the same language, but like, you know, it's a different age language, if you know what I mean. But then if you can connect with that different age language, then it'd be easy for that age language to understand what you want to teach them. I think I made my point.